Good morning.
Huh? Where am I? Why does he have candles lit? Is he trying to seduce me?
How you feeling?
Oh, nah, he's trying to f***. This man, Gojo, is the light-skinned final boss. And bro isn't even light-skinned. He really out here putting every other light-skinned stare to shame. Donkey? Nah. Chris Griffin? Nah. That one nigga on the street? Nah. Those niggas at MAPPA deadass spent half their budget just to make sure this nigga had the most light-skinned stare possible. Every time this man blinked, it's another week those animators are not seeing their children. Like, it's almost unfair how sexy this man is. Anyways, that's not what we're here for. We're here to find out this man's drip power level. No more stroking his cock, let's get straight into this. Alright, so Megumi was about to get munched by this gremlin of a curse. Ugh, why does his tongue look like Donzo's arm? Either way, it throws this dude into the wall and his dogs start melting. Megumi really about to turn into this thing's afternoon snack, so this nigga eats a dory, starts trying to box it with his bare fucking hand.
Is this nigga serious?
Dude had literally no business trying to fight this thing, and now he's about to get munched. So this man pops up perk 30, obliterates this nigga, and starts absolutely tweaking. I say this every episode, but these anime niggas are really addicts. Anyways, that perk was supposed to be for Gojo, and now Megumi's trying to think about what the fuck he should do. Not to fear, however, the light skin's here, and Gojo's like, damn, nigga, you got fucked up? Nah. You finna lose all your hoes when I post this. Ah, Tanisha just said your ass smell like fucking dog food, nigga. Anyways, you get my perk? Excuse me, sir? I'm so sorry. I took your perk 30. Wait, deadass? Deadass, bro. Alright, bro, score up. Sukuna tries to sneak Gojo right off the bat, but clearly he didn't know what caliber of light skin he was up against. Dog is sitting on his ass! Bro starts teleporting.
Oop, over here. I'm over here. So close.
Then he whispered in his ear like,
hey, sorry, bruh. That nigga finna tell the hoes what happened here, so I'm gonna have to style on you a little bit.
Bro hit him with a 360, sent that man spinning into the air. He gets up and tries to get one in, literally annihilating the building behind him, but this nigga is just smiling. I think it's safe to say that's an easy plus 100,000, plus another 50 just cause he's light skin. All right, so moving on. Gojo's on his way home getting driven by this guy when suddenly his light skin senses start tingling. He tells his Uber driver to stop the car, gets out, and is like,
come out, man, I know you hiding.
Then this nigga jumps out, screaming like a fucking weasel.
He's ugly as shit. He's definitely trying to steal some of Gojo's light skin power.
Dude throws a mud titty at him that just busts his lava out of its nipples. And this man's over here smirking like he won. Obviously, he ain't no Gojo drinks titty milk for breakfast, nigga. Anyway, so now the battle is really about to start. Light skin Jesus versus lava head Squidward. Volcano nigga sends out some bugs, and Gojo just absolutely cock blocks them with two fingers. But then his light skin senses start tingling again, and the bugs explode. He gets out of there, but the ugly nigga is determined. Runs up on this dude and slaps him in the face with the Holy Ghost fire. Got this nigga looking like heat flame. Then he hits him with an open palm so powerful, it don't even look like it's from the same damn show.
Well, that's one less light skin on Earth. Now I just have to find that nigga Drake. Someone's gotta deal with that man.
Huh?
Come on, dude. You know if you fuck up my hair, the bitch is not finna fuck with me no more.
The fuck, nigga? How are you still alive?
You see, only sexy niggas can touch me.
Huh?
Come here, let me show you.
I don't trust this man. He sounds zesty as hell. But let me see what he's talking about.
You see, this is the gap between our rizz.
There's no way.
Basically,
you get no bitches, nigga.
Gojo starts pummeling this man, bro. You fat, your breath stank, and you have no fucking swag. Now take this spirit bomb of rizz, bitch.
No, not the rizz. No!
Senbro running for his life, swinging from trees like a monkey.
Damn, I said monkey like I had some hate behind it.
Anyways, you already know light skins don't take no for an answer. Look at how he's holding this dude's face. He looks like he's about to blow his back out. And he's smiling the whole time. I don't know why bro's fighting so hard against it, bro.
To be honest, bro, if it was me, I would have let it happen. No homo, pause.
Volcano Head tries to hit him with a Kamehameha, but Gojo teleports behind him and kicks him so hard, I thought I was watching Blue Lock. So then this dude Gojo gets the most marvelous idea. He goes and grabs Chidori and is like,
sorry, this is my student Itadori from Rizz Academy, light skin in training. He's actually here to observe.
That's him, sir, that's him? The broke nigga with no hose?
I ain't broke, you bitch! I could go band for band with you right now!
Don't worry,
All broke niggas think they can go band for band with you. Volcano dude's had enough. He whips out his domain expansion, starts cooking these boys in a literal volcano, but then Gojo starts to take off his blindfold and releases his own final move.
Domain expansion. Infinite rizz.
He showed this nigga every rizz technique known to man, and it was so powerful, his mind couldn't comprehend it. He literally got rizz to death. Give him a plus 5 million just for that excellent display of sauce, bro.
Okay, so next up, Buff Nigga and Itadori are in the middle of trying to jump this creature. They are literally just fucking with this nigga, bro. They gave this man a case of the beats. No other anime competes with Jujutsu Kaisen when it comes to jumping, bro. They're clapping the teleport, and Musclehead himself is even showing off some fucking light skin behavior. Elsewhere, this bald ass nigga looking like Mr. Clean trying to fight this old man. I don't think he saw my last video because he would have taken precautions. He was tucking hella shit, not knowing he was up against the next upcoming SoundCloud rapper. His rap name's Lil Dementia. Anyway, before anything could pop off, this nigga Gojo's in the sky looking light skin as fuck, hitting that Goku pose. Immediately, everybody on the battlefield starts feeling this nigga's light skin spiritual pressure. Gojo's like, oh, is that an ugly bald nigga?
Hey you.
Oh, it's my chance. Rizz.
Be gone, nigga.
I don't even know what this nigga did. He just fucked him up.
Then he uses every light skin molecule in his body to summon a giant bolt and snipes whatever that thing is.
After crippling one nigga and then literally just annihilating another, dude gives a thumbs up and just smiles at the camera.
Man, just give him 2 million. I can't even think of another light skin that compares to this man's power.
Okay, now I'm about to talk about the movie. So if you haven't seen it yet, still keep watching the video, but just know there's gonna be some movie spoilers in here, but don't click off, keep watching.
Anyway, so Gojo's trying to introduce his new student to Rizz Academy. Looking at him, you would think bro got zero rizz with no badges, but as soon as this nigga steps on the floor, it's revealed he got that silent rizz. Apparently, when he was a jit, the girl he rizzed up got ran over by a fucking car, but the rizz was so powerful she fucking couldn't leave him, so she cursed him.
Gojo's a strict ass sensei though. He sent this nigga on a rizzpedition. Okay, I'm done with this rizz shit. I'm so sorry.
Now it's the final battle. Light-skinned Miguel versus light-skinned Gojo. Before the battle starts, this man Gojo sees an ugly, hideous creature in the fucking background. You already know how Gojo feel about that shit though, so he blew this nigga's head to smithereens. They got to boxing, and just by looking at Miguel, you can tell this nigga was some kind of stripper. Look at how he twirling that whip. Gojo is not here to play with him though. Hit this nigga with a three-piece acrobatic combo and immediately starts sprinting after him. Nigga started doing stunts like it was Mission Impossible. Bro thinks he's Tom Cruise. After witnessing Gojo punch an ogre 5 times the size of him, Miguel starts booking it like any other reasonable nigga would. Dude starts swinging from shit like he's trying to be the next Miles Morales or something. Gojo teleports in front of this nigga, grabs him by the throat, and just yeets this dude. Like, this isn't even a fight anymore. This is just bullying. Nah, this is worse than that. Oh my god. This is hate crime.
He definitely whispered the hard R to him after one of those last punches. Anyways, he beat this dude so bad, he decided to work for him. Give this dude a plus 10 million. Gojo is him.
And that's it for this video, man. Sub, like, and I'll see y'all in the next one. Thank you for 30K. Peace.